This program includes a PDF of reference materials. Simon & Schuster Audio presents A Curious Mind, The Secret to a Bigger Life by Brian Grazer with Charles Fishman. Read by Norbert Leo Butz, with an introduction by Brian Grazer.
Introduction. A Curious Mind and a Curious Book. I have no special talents. I'm only passionately curious. Albert Einstein. It seems like a good idea to start a book about curiosity by asking an obvious question. What's a guy like me doing writing a book about curiosity? I'm a movie and TV producer. I live immersed in the most densely populated epicenter of entertainment in the world, Hollywood. Whatever picture you have of the life of a Hollywood movie producer, I've probably lived it. We often have 10 or more movies and TV shows in production at a time. So work means meeting with actors, writers, directors, musicians. The phone calls with agents, producers, studio heads, stars start well before I reach the office and often follow me home in the car. I fly to movie sets, I screen trailers, I go to red carpet premieres. My days are hectic. They're overscheduled. They're sometimes frustrating. Usually, they're great fun. They're never dull. But I'm not a journalist or a professor. I'm not a scientist. I don't go home at night and research psychology as a secret hobby. I'm a Hollywood producer. So what am I doing writing a book about curiosity? Without curiosity, none of this would have happened. More than intelligence or persistence or connections, curiosity has allowed me to live the life I wanted. Curiosity is what gives energy and insight to everything else I do. I love show business. I love telling stories. But I loved being curious long before I loved the movie business. For me, curiosity infuses everything with a sense of possibility. Curiosity has, quite literally, been the key to my success and also the key to my happiness. And yet, for all the value that curiosity has brought to my life and my work, when I look around, I don't see people talking about it, writing about it, encouraging it, and using it nearly as widely as they could. Curiosity has been the most valuable quality, the most important resource, the central motivation of my life. I think curiosity should be as much a part of our culture, our educational system, our workplaces, as concepts like creativity and innovation. That's why I decided to write a book about curiosity. It made my life better, and it still does. It can make your life better too. I am called a movie producer. I even call myself that. But really, what I am is a storyteller. A couple of years ago, I started thinking about curiosity as a value I wanted to share, a quality I wanted to inspire in other people. I thought what I'd really like to do is sit down and tell a few stories about what curiosity has done for me. I'd like to tell stories about how curiosity has helped me make movies. I'd like to tell stories about how curiosity has helped me be a better boss, a better friend, a better businessman, a better dinner guest. I'd like to tell stories about the sheer joy of discovery that open-ended curiosity offers. That's the kind of joy we have as kids when we learn things just because we're curious. You can keep doing that as an adult, and it's just as much fun. The most effective way to pass on these stories, to illustrate the power and variety of curiosity, is to write them down. So that's what you're listening to now. I teamed up with journalist and author Charles Fishman, and over the course of 18 months, we talked two or three times a week. We've had more than 100 conversations, every one of them about curiosity. I know very well how important curiosity has been to my life. As you will hear in the upcoming chapters, I long ago figured out how to be systematic about using curiosity to help me tell stories, to help me make good movies, to help me learn about parts of the world far from Hollywood. One of the things I've done for 35 years is sit down and have conversations with people from outside show business, curiosity conversations, with people immersed in everything from particle physics to etiquette. But I've never turned my curiosity on curiosity itself. So I've spent the last 2 years thinking about it, asking questions about it, trying to understand how it works. In the course of exploring and unpacking it, in the course of diagramming curiosity and dissecting its anatomy, we discovered something interesting and surprising. There's a spectrum of curiosity, like there's a spectrum of colors of light. Curiosity comes in different shades and different intensities for different purposes. The technique is the same, asking questions, regardless of the subject, but the mission, the motivation, and the tone vary. The curiosity of a detective trying to solve a murder is very different from the curiosity of an architect trying to get the floor plan right for a family's house. The result is, admittedly, a slightly unusual book. We tell it in the first person because the central stories come from my life and work. Partly, then, the book is a portrait of me, but in fact, it's more a working portrait of curiosity itself. Curiosity has taken me on a lifetime of journeys. Asking questions about curiosity in the last 2 years has been fascinating. And one thing I know about curiosity, it's democratic. Anyone, anywhere, of any age or education level can use it. One reminder of curiosity's quiet power is that there are still countries on Earth where you have to be very careful at whom you aim your curiosity. Being curious in Russia has proven fatal. Being curious in China can land you in prison. But even if your curiosity is suppressed, you can't lose it. It's always on, always waiting to be unleashed. The goal of a curious mind is simple. I want to show you how valuable curiosity can be and remind you of how much fun it is. I want to show you how to use it and how you can use it. Life isn't about finding the answers. It's about asking the questions.
Chapter 1. There is no cure for curiosity. The cure for boredom is curiosity. There is no cure for curiosity. Dorothy Parker. One Thursday afternoon, the summer after I graduated from the University of Southern California, USC, I was sitting in my apartment in Santa Monica with the windows open, thinking about how to get some work until I started law school at USC in the fall. Suddenly, through the windows, I overheard two guys talking just outside. One said, "Oh my God, I had the cushiest job at Warner Brothers. I got paid for 8 hours of work every day, and it was usually just an hour." This guy got my attention. I opened the window a little more so I wouldn't miss the rest of the conversation, and I quietly closed the curtain. The guy went on to say he had been a legal clerk. "I just quit today. My boss was a man named Peter Connect." I was amazed. Sounded perfect to me. I went right to the telephone, dialed 411, and asked for the main number at Warner Brothers. I still remember it, 954-6000. I called the number and asked for Peter Connect. An assistant in his office answered, and I said to her, "I'm going to USC Law School in the fall, and I'd like to meet with Mr. Connect about the law clerk job that's open." Connect got on the line. "Can you be here tomorrow at 3 p.m.?" he asked. I met with him on Friday at 3 p.m. He hired me at 3:15, and I started work at Warner Brothers the next Monday. I didn't quite realize it at the time, but two incredible things happened that day in the summer of 1974. First, my life had just changed forever. When I reported for work as a legal clerk that Monday, they gave me a windowless office the size of a small closet. At that moment, I had found my life's work. From that tiny office, I joined the world of show business. I never again worked at anything else. I also realized that curiosity had saved my ass that Thursday afternoon. I've been curious as long as I can remember. As a boy, I peppered my mother and my grandmother with questions, some of which they could answer, some of which they couldn't. By the time I was a young man, curiosity was part of the way I approached the world every day. My kind of curiosity hasn't changed much since I eavesdropped on those guys at my apartment complex. It hasn't actually changed that much since I was an antsy 12-year-old boy. My kind of curiosity is a little wider.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.